complete our work and present it to the customer, we can export a fully customized PDF document with all the details of our project. This includes all the renders and views that we have for our design, the technical drawings with details of our layouts and dimensions, and then the list of products that we've used with all the quantities and prices. So in this video, we'll see how we can export this kind of PDF document. So to export to PDF, we click on this button here, Export Blueprints, or we can go onto File and then Export to PDF. This opens up this PDF export wizard, which is divided into steps. So in the first step, we can choose some general document settings. For example, we can choose the paper size, A4, A3, or legal or letter, which are US formats. We can choose if we want to have a vertical page or an horizontal page. We can provide some information like the project name, the client name, and so on. We can decide if we want to include a cover page, which is the first page here in this example PDF. So if I don't want to have this kind of cover, I can simply turn this option off. We can choose if we want to include a page header, which is this part here on top of each page in the document. If we want to have the footer, which includes some information from of my user, the project name, and if we want to have the page numbers, which are here on the bottom right. So we have all these general options on the first step. Going on to the next step in the wizard, we can select which elements of our project we want to print in our document. So we can choose if we want to include our camera views, which are the renders, or the simple 3D views that we set up in the render tab. If we want to include the 2D drawings of our walls and flooring, we will see all the details of how to set these up later. And if we want to include the list of prices and quantities for our tiles and for our objects. So in this example, I'm going to choose all of these. I can select them all like this and then drag them onto the right. So this means they will be part of the document. I can also decide to change the sorting. For example, I can move the 2D surface drawings in first place, and this will mean that they will be printed before the camera views in my PDF. For now, I'm just going to keep the default, so camera views, then the 2D drawings, and then a list of tiles and a list of objects. Okay, so if I included the camera views on the top, then going on to the next step will let me choose the camera views layout. So from here I can decide if I want to have just one camera per page, like in the example we saw earlier, or if we want to have two, three, or four for each single page. For example, here I have another PDF where I have set to have four cameras per page, and you can see here the result. So once we choose the camera layout that we prefer, we can move on to the next step, and here we can actually choose which cameras we want to include, and then also the order of these cameras. For example, I could select this camera here and place it on the top, since it's a nice view from the top of my room and I want to show this first in my document. Okay, going on, then we can choose some settings for the 2D drawings. Just here above you can see a diagram of how these pages will look like on the PDF. So on the left side we have some settings for the 2D view of our surfaces, floors and walls and so on. So we can decide if we want to include the tile border lines, if we want to have the tile textures or just with a simple color, if we want to include the object border lines and the surface dimensions, so a dimension for each edge of the surface. So I've done here some different examples that just to show you what different views you can obtain. So for example, on this document, I've decided not to include the object borderlines, but only the tiles with their texture, and also to include the dimension lines for each surface. On the right side, we can choose the settings for this annotation area. So we can choose if we want to include the grout previews, like I did in this document. You can see each page has some details about the grout that's been used. We can choose if we want to include the tile previews, which I've included here as well. So each page will show which tiles have been used with their information. And then we can choose if we want to include a blank text lines, which in this case I haven't included. So I made another example here. This instead shows the object borders but doesn't show the tiling. So this could be a different document that we could provide, for example, to the installers of these of the sanitary ware, maybe. And in this case, I've excluded the tiles and grout previews on the right, but I've included this blank section for comments. Okay, so after we choose all of these settings, when we move on, we can again here see the full list of surfaces. By default, the main surfaces have already been selected. Here on the left, I can see all the minor surfaces, which I can, if I need to, select and drag to the right. And then again here, we can order them in the way that we prefer. Okay, before continuing to show how the PDF export process works, I just want to explain another important thing. Here you see we have another example where you can see that I've also included some dimension lines to show, for example, the distance between this sanitary to the corner of the wall and this other one as well, to show the height of this sanitary here on this wall, and also the height of this tiling. These are some key sizes that maybe I need to communicate to the builders for this bathroom. To add these dimensions, we need to go back to the Layout Tiles tab. So here we've selected this wall on the 3D view, which you can see here, and so we can see this wall here on the 2D canvas. We can use this tool, the ruler, that we can find here on the toolbar, and we can use this to take some measurements and to place some dimension lines. So as we move the mouse inside the 3D view, as we get close to this sanitary here, we can see these blue points, and these correspond to the midpoint and all the vertices of the object. So I'm going to click on the midpoint to start my dimension, and then I'm going to go close to the edge of this wall, and you see here we have another snap point, so I'm going to click again, and then all I need to do is to drag the mouse so I can decide exactly where I want to place my dimension line. We can do this again also for the tiling, so I'm going to select the ruler again. I can choose one of these purple snap points which correspond to the vertices of each tile on the wall. So I'm going to choose this one, for example. Drag the mouse up to this other point here. Okay. And then I'm going to drag the mouse to the right so I can place my dimension line, for example, here. Okay, so once I've placed all my dimensions, when I export the PDF, these dimensions will be included in the document, as we just saw. Okay, so going back to the export process, you can see that in this example, the last part of the document includes the table with our tiles and the table with our objects. So during the export process, we can choose the tile table settings. So first of all, we can choose which columns of the table we want to include. So we've selected these ones, for example, the preview image, the item code, item name. But if we, for example, want to exclude some of these, for example, we don't want to show the brand name, or for example, we don't want to show the unit price, but just the total, we can exactly choose which columns to view. You see here, this is the result, so we could have excluded any of these columns, or even change the order of these columns, for example, place the name before the code or anything that we prefer. Going on, we can then decide exactly which tiles we want to include in the document, for example, only these three, and again the order of the products in the table, and then the same thing for the objects. So we choose which columns we want to include, their ordering, and then exactly which objects should be placed in the objects table. Okay, so as you can see, we've easily created a nice document that we can give to the customer for confirming a sale. Or we can also personalize in a different way, as we saw, for example, without objects or without the tiles, with sizes or without sizes and so on, to share maybe with the builders and the tilers who need to do the construction work.